You've read the title and it said it's a reboot. It's because I deleted the original first episode due to the issues like... It's boring and hard to understand. So that's why I put some changes for our new first episode. From writing to the finished project. And to be honest, I tried to make this thing interesting, but I made it more boring than before, so... Grab your pills right now because this video might be your new lullaby. Or the worst episode ever, I don't know, you be the judge.
A set is a well-defined collection of distinct objects. The objects in a set must be clear and unambiguous. This one is a set of digits, but this one is not a set because 1 and 7 appear twice. This is a multi-set. In writing a set, uppercase letters are used in naming a set. Curly brackets are used to enclose the objects of a set.
Hold up, I'm just thinking. Should we include puns or jokes in this episode to make it less boring?
No, you only make things worse.
Come on, man! We have to set up the jokes! You're making the audience upset!
Listen to me, you piece of disgusting thing that came from your butt.
You mean diarrhea?
We're trying to make this reboot better because the actual first episode isn't good enough. So for the sake of mankind, if you ever make this worse, I'll kick you out of math class forever. You understand me?
But I'm the main host of this show and the director, so you can't kick me out. Describing a set has two ways, roster notation and set builder notation. I know another way of describing a set is using a description, but... Roster notation is about listing the objects of a set like this. When a list is too long, an ellipsis is used to indicate that the list goes on. Set builder notation is about using statement or condition about the objects of a set like this. A vertical bar here means where or such that. The thing stated here means A is the set of all numbers n where n is an integer in the range from 0 to 9 inclusive. It means it's just 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Other references use colon to mean where or such that, but I feel more use in using vertical bars in situations like this. Let's talk about empty set. An empty set or null set is a set that contains no objects, which makes the set empty inside. So if you think you are empty inside, you're actually not. You have a set of internal organs inside you. If you don't have anything inside you, how are you still alive watching this video?
What are you talking about?
I have no idea. If a set contains something, then it's not an empty set anymore. That something is called member or object or element of the set. This is the set membership symbol. This symbol means element of, object of, member of, belongs to, or is in. For example, the brain is an object of the set of internal organs. Well, that is something we don't object. This symbol means not element of, not object of, not member of, doesn't belong to, or isn't in. For example, an apple is not an object of the set of internal organs. Because an apple is a fruit, and you know what they say about apples? An apple a day is 365 apples a year. 366 if it's a leap year. Now let's talk about finite set and infinite set. A finite set is a set in which we can list all the objects and we know how many they are. For example, the 26 letters of the English alphabet. We can write the set as this one as long as we know that there are 26 of them. An infinite set, well, let's just say have infinite objects, that there's always more than we can count. I mean, how big is infinity, am I right? Am I right? Take counting numbers for example. This is an infinite set because the counting goes on forever. Red, it's your turn. Make this thing interesting, okay? I'm counting on you.
I hate you. Let's talk about subsets and supersets. If any object of a set, let's say set A, is in another set, let's say B, then A is a subset of B or B is a superset of A. The subset symbol means is subset of, is contained in, or is included in. The superset symbol means is superset of, contains, or includes. Take note that an empty set is a subset of every set, and each set is a subset of itself. Two sets are equal if and only if they are subsets of each other. That is to say, if A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A, then any object in A is an object in B, and any object in B is an object in A. All the objects in A is the same as all the objects in B. Hence, A and B are equal. Or, if A is equal to B and A is a subset of A, by substitution, A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A. However, if A is a subset of B but B is not a subset of A, then all the objects in A are the objects in B, but not all objects in B are objects in A. If that is the case, then A is a proper subset of B or B is a proper superset of A. Let's move on to power sets.
I'm gonna explain about power sets because it's hard to understand, I think. Let's say we have set S. We list all the subsets of S, including itself and an empty set. And then we have a set of all subsets of S. This set of all subsets of S is a power set. A power set of S is the set of all subsets of S. You still don't understand power sets? Well, that's okay because I don't have the power to tell you what they are useful at. Now let's talk about cardinality. Cardinality, order, or size of the set, is the number of objects of the set. This symbol means cardinality of set A, or order of set A, or size of set A. Let's cite some examples. Cardinality of set A is 10, and cardinality of set B is 3.
Let's talk about universal set. The universal set, at least for a given collection of set theoretic computations, is the set of all possible objects. Declaring our universal set depends on what is our well-defined set. Let me put it this way. If we have a set of pastries as a well-defined set, then the universal set is all the foods we eat. And if we have a set of animals as a well-defined set, then the universal set is all the living creatures.
We are now in Venn diagram and the operation on sets. Venn diagram is a way of depicting the relationship between sets. In a Venn diagram, the rectangle is the universal set, while sets and subsets are the circles. We are going to use a Venn diagram to show the operations on sets. The union of two sets A and B is the collection of all objects that are in either A or B, more like adding together the two sets. From the sets we have right now, A union B is 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. The intersection of two sets A and B is the collection of all objects that are in both A and B, more like something in common in the two sets. From the sets we have right now, A intersect B is 3, 5, 7.
The difference of two sets A and B is the collection of all objects that are in A but not in B. Take note that the difference of A and B is not the same as the difference of B and A. From the sets here, the difference of A and B is 0, 2, and the difference of B and A is 1, 9. The symmetric difference of two sets A and B is the set of all objects that are in one and only one of the sets. It is the union of the differences of two sets. From the sets here, the symmetric difference of A and B is 0, 1, 2, 9.
The complement, and let me say it's not complement because complement is something to complete something, while complement is saying nice things. The complement of set A is a set of all objects that are in the universal set but not in A. From the sets we have right now, here's the complement of A, and here's the complement of B. Oh, I forgot about these joint sets. If A intersect B is an empty set, or there are no objects common in A and B, then A and B are disjoint sets. Let's finish this video with De Morgan's laws. There were two laws about the sets A and B. I think it's better to show it than to tell it. I want to tell you more about set theory like Cartesian product and principle of inclusion and exclusion, but I think that's enough set theory for now. So how do we end this video?
How about the conclusion?
Okay! A set is resting on your buttocks! Like here, I sat on a chair! Ha 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 ha